Kids are about to have 2 weeks off, so it's time to teach your kids about science using items that you've got right in your kitchen pantry. And you can even turn some of this stuff into a great gift for Christmas.
Kitchen Pantry scientist Liz Heinecke is here with us to show us how to put together homemade science kits. And this is a great idea for a gift.
It's inexpensive. It's fun. It's a great thing for siblings to get each other.
Oh, yeah.
It's screen-free and, like, seriously, hours of fun.
Yeah. If you give kids... So I just bought a plastic container at Target, mm-hmm. but you might have one of these lying around the
sure.
house. Go to a grocery store, Target. Fill it up with things like, oh, it's leaking, baking soda, vinegar, like right here, hours yeah. of entertainment. If you get some balloons, they can inflate balloons using these ingredients with the water bottle.
Oh, that cool. is fun.
All
yeah.
this stuff is on my website. If you get them some borax laundry detergent and glue slime.
Right.
Right. And what is better than slime? Nothing.
Nothing.
Plus,
is better.
Fun to give your kids borax detergent and have them figure out what exactly is
yeah,
happening. Why am I getting detergent? This is the worst present ever.
That's awesome. You
this
should
is
wrap
normal
that,
for you.
Wrap that separately. That could be like
your
part
kids
one
are
of
like, yep, it's Christmas again.
We're teaching them about being grateful.
Borax
and
for mine.
Doing laundry.
Mentos.
Mentos, right?
We all know.
We
that
all know trend. What that does.
It's
yeah.
the best.
The best.
It still is. Yeah.
Gummy worms on my website. You can make frankenworms. You can make the worms wiggle around with baking soda and vinegar.
Fun.
Plus, they will just enjoy eating them.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Let's be honest.
So you have a whole list of all these kind of things.
I have a whole list. The great thing about it is just give it to them. Let them experiment
let them
with
yeah.
it. They don't even need a recipe. Just
that
let
is
them
the key.
Play
let
with
them
it.
Have
yeah,
the fun.
Yeah, it teaches them creativity, right?
And speaking of fun, I know
okay.
I'm not a kid, but I've been eyeing this because it looks so cool.
These are awesome. And with the borax from their science kit and a few mm-hmm. pipe cleaners, which you could also throw in their science kit, they can make a super saturated solution of borax. That just means that this solution is holding more borax molecules than a room temperature solution would hold.
Oh, wow.
So you get water hot, 3 cups of water, 10 tablespoons of borax. This has started to come out of solution. You dissolve it till it's mostly clear.
So it looks like this.
So it looks like this.
But because it's super saturated, it wants to go somewhere.
It wants to come out of that solution. So if it encounters something like an impurity or perhaps a pipe cleaner fiber,
oh.
it will start to form crystals on it. And I grew these in like a day. They grow really fast. They make these pretty ornaments.
That's so pretty.
Kids can mess around with them. I was trying to add some glow-in-the-dark paint to my
it's
solution
really
to make
cool.
glow-in-the-dark snowflakes.
And this is the color of the pipe cleaner?
The pipe cleaner, yeah. They can add food coloring to the solution. I mean, like I said, let them experiment.
I gotta say, when you started with this makes super saturated borax. I was like, this sounds like a lame one.
Yep.
But that's super cool.
That is super cool.
They're beautiful.
What are we doing with the pine cones?
Okay,
here?
You can also use alum crystals. So alum, like you find at the grocery store, the
yeah.
co-op. This is a fun one. You just paint. For this, you need seed crystals. So you put some glue on here.
Okay.
Then you sprinkle some little alum crystals on it, let it dry, and put it in a super saturated alum solution. This is on my website, too.
Hmm.
But the cool thing we discovered is the crystals start to grow. The pine cones close back up from the water. They
oh,
rehydrate.
Funny.
We didn't
oh,
even.
Wow.
Science is great. We didn't even know this would happen.
Didn't
so
expect
they,
it.
No, they close tightly up, and then when they dry out, they open up again, and they're full of crystals.
Perfect.
I mean, this is
really
beautiful.
Like super
so
fun.
So you need to go to the website.
Yeah.
You can get all of the information.
It's all there.
On Liz's KitchenPantryScientist.com. Go to WCCO.com. We will get you there. Thanks, Liz.
Yeah. Thanks for having me on.
Here's that phone number. One more.